Hello everyone, Transport Arthur here. In this video, I'll show you how to fix unresponsive buttons on the Game Boy Color. So you'll need a precision Phillips head screwdriver and a tri-wing screwdriver to make this repair. First thing you need to do is to remove any game cartridges and batteries from the Game Boy, then remove the 6 tri-wing screws. Two of them are located in the battery compartment. This is shown in the video right now. So just take care when removing these two tri-wing screws as they might fall into the console as there are holes in the battery compartment and these two tri-wing screws are very small. After removing the screws, just place them in a safe place. We don't want to be losing any screws during the repair. So after removing the screws, carefully remove the back panel of the Game Boy. There is nothing housed in the back panel, but take care when removing the panel as there is a ribbon cable located at the top of the console. Once the Game Boy is open, there are 3 mini Phillips head screws located at the bottom of the Game Boy. This is shown in the video right now. Use your precision head screwdriver to unscrew these screws. Also, be careful not to touch the motherboard of the Game Boy at the top. After the screws have been unscrewed, slowly flip the motherboard up towards the ribbon cable. Be careful when flipping so the ribbon cable and the speaker, which is located at the bottom, aren't damaged. Then remove the broken silicone buttons. I've already removed them from an earlier inspection. Here is the comparison between the broken buttons and the new ones that we are going to replace with. Before replacing the buttons, just get a cotton tip and just clean the Game Boy as there should be a lot of grime in the Game Boy from years and years of use. After cleaning the Game Boy, you can place the new buttons onto the Game Boy. There are holes to assist you on placing the right buttons in the right area. Give the buttons a push so they are nice and snug. After replacing the buttons, flip back the motherboard. Take care when flipping it back as the ribbon cable might get damaged. Also, the speaker might have popped out, so move it back into the speaker housing. You also have to make sure the Game Boy's motherboard is flush with the housing. After that, you can re-screw the 3 mini Phillips head screws onto the motherboard. So finally, just place the back housing back onto the Game Boy and re-screw the 6 tri-wing screws back onto the Game Boy. That's how easy it is to replace the broken buttons of the Game Boy Color. I hope this video helped you getting your Game Boy Color back and working. If you have any questions, just write them in the description and I'll answer them. If you guys are new, please like this video and subscribe to the channel to help it grow. Thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next video.